It is the new frontier. The Bakken has pioneered the idea of fracking shale. It really is the leading edge of what is going to be probably a revolution.
There's over 4 billion barrels of recoverable oil.
Bakken Formation is the largest resource oil play in the lower 48 states.
It's going to take a lot of time. It's going to take a lot of manpower. And right now we're ramping up very rapidly. And we're well on the way to doubling the size of the town.
The jobs are here. We often say that if a worker comes here and they'll find a job in a day, but then they have to find a place to live, and that's where the challenge comes in.
And with the economy the way it is, we have to come up here to where the work is. Cotton hunters survive when you don't have the means to purchase a home for the, you know, because the price is up there so high. I'm not sure what the weather's going to be because I haven't spent a winter up here yet, so we'll have to see how that's going to go. That's why we're trying to hunker down and button these up.
Plus, I'm going to add a room on over on the side here. Mm-hmm. A lot of these places, even though it's hard to find because they're all taken up.
Yeah, North Dakota is a pretty inhospitable place in the wintertime. Minus 40 is not uncommon. So you have to provide a place where these guys are comfortable.
Keeping the guys warm and a good meal in their belly and something fun to do in the evening it helps the job performance immensely.
This camp was actually used at the Winter Olympics. Fed 1,600 people out of the building.
When I got here on site, this was nothing but a field and a hill, and in 3 months we'll have beds and serving meals.
Not only are we providing it, we've lived it here during the construction phase. And it means a lot to these guys. It means a lot to us out here to have a place to come stay. It can be a home. The guys have their own rooms that they can come to. They can make it their own space.
Everybody that becomes a resident of this camp will be provided with first-rate service. They'll have a climate-controlled environment. Everything is contained in what we call Arctic corridors.
Now this camp will be able to house, in the initial stage, 251 people. We'll be serving 3 meals a day. We have a recreation room, a laundry. You know, we're going to do some steak night in the kitchen. We're going to have smoking Saturdays out here where we'll barbecue.
Well, it makes me happy to help the client achieve their end state by accomplishing their project. That's the key here.
Housing can make the difference between a worker who stays and one who leaves.
And as a community, we want to make sure that those workers have a good place to live, they have food to eat, and the quality of life that they want.
Well, the accommodations were more than I expected, a lot more.
As soon as I stepped through the door, it was like Alice in Wonderland, you know.
And they're very efficient, and I enjoy the fact that you have a washer and dryer, and a stove and microwave, television, all of our towels, bedding. I was shocked, actually.
I think it's a place in a good location right off the highway for everybody to get to and from work quickly and safely.
It has the basic comforts. I mean, you had left your home, yes, and you had left your family, but they try to replace that just by keeping you comfortable here.
It makes everything easier. Our jobs, our stress levels go down, knowing that we have a place to live.
It takes a lot on a person's body, so the more you can relax, the more you can set yourself in for the evening, it really means a lot to a person who works in the hours that we do.
Target Logistics is obviously a big player in this. It's been one of the largest that's been on the scene.
I think Target Logistics did catch the vision of what was going on here early on.
It's an honor, really, to be a part of this and to be able to provide homes for these guys.